Hello everyone, welcome back to Sofikul. In today's tutorial, I will show you how to convert low resolution vector clip art images into high resolution in Photoshop. One of my subscribers, Stephen Haster, requested me to make a video that shows to enhance the quality of the clip art that we download from Google. Now the main thing is that if I go to Google and search for clip art, we will find lots of clip art, and they're very good looking. You might want to use these clip arts. Now I would like to go with this nice fox clip art image for today's tutorial. Save the image. Now if anyone wants to use these clip art for their personal work, they will face the low resolution quality problem and they can't use it properly. So this video is about how to enhance or make high resolution of your vector image in Photoshop. After following my steps, you can easily use the vector image for any kind of personal work that you download from Google. So watch the tutorial carefully until the end. And thank you, Stephen, for the request. Now if you are new on my channel, be sure to subscribe and also press the bell icon so that you might never miss any chance to learn new things about Photoshop. Let's jump to our Photoshop. Now we are here in the magical world of Photoshop. I have already opened the vector clip art in Photoshop. Now first let me explain why you need to enhance the quality of vector clip art you downloaded from Google. If I zoom closer to the vector fox, you will see the pixels are showing. And we know if you want to print any documents, you must need the file in 300p resolution. Then you can print the file and it will look very good. But if I go to the image size, you can see the resolution is 72 ppi. So this the file that is for the screen, not the print. And if you print this fox, you will not get good quality. So we need to increase the resolution of the image. Increase the resolution 300. Now if you see the preview box, the before image and after one, also if you see there is some deep line. To fix these, go to resample and apply to preserve details 2.0. Now you can see it. For more, increase the reduce noise slider. Now if you don't find the preserve details 2.0 in here, don't worry. If you are using a lower version of Photoshop, you also have the option. But you need to turn that on. To do that, go to the edit, and then preference and use the technology previews. Now check the enable preserve details 2.0. And hit OK. Then again go to the image, and image size. Increase the resolution 300. And use the resample preserve details 2.0. Increase the noise and reduce 100%, your vector might be different, so adjust it as you want. And then if you like to reduce the file size, just decrease the size of the image. And you will see the file is now smaller. Then hit OK. Now we are done. Next, I would like to increase the canvas size. For that, go to the toolbar and take a crop tool. Click on the canvas. Then adjust the size from the all side. Now if you follow that, if you will see the image is filled with white, and a background is here, but the image has a transparent layer. Hit OK. Now you can see the background image. All of this happening because the layer is locked, you can see it in here. Now if I increase the canvas size with the crop tool, you can see the background is transparent. To fill that, go to layer, new, background from the layer. Now it will fill the background with the background color of Photoshop. For example, go back one step and change the background color. And apply the same steps. You can see how to change the background color on canvas. Now you can see how the tricks work. Then again follow the same steps and fill the background with white. Now we will give the final touch to the vector to get the perfect edges and make the image a fresh new vector. First press Ctrl or Command plus J to make a duplicate layer. Then convert the layer into a smart object. Then go to Filter, Noise, then Dust and Scratches. Now in here we'll make the adjustments with the slider. It will give more sharp edges. But don't apply too much radius. If you apply, you will see a horrible effect. So go with a small radius, it will give the vector and sharp edges to the image. And for the final step, we will give more sharpening to the edges. Go to the filter, sharpen, and sharpen edges. Now we are done and enhance the quality of the vector clip art. If you like to go with these, you can use it. Or if you like to enhance the color also a little bit, you can go to the adjustment and take vibrance. Increase the vibrance. You will not see too much difference. Again go to the adjustments layer and take levels adjustments. Now adjust the slider to enhance the color. Now we are done. We make the low quality vector clip art into high quality. Now if I zoom closer to the image pixels will not break, and the most important part of the vector is the sharp and smooth edges of the clip art we get. Now you can use this vector clip art for any kind of personal work. And the tutorial is done. Now, I just show you how to enhance the quality of vector clip art in Photoshop. This is the best technique to convert any low resolution vector into high resolution. I show you all the tricks and steps very carefully. And thank you so much, Stephen, for the request. Anyone have any kind of request video, let me know in the comment section below. I will try to make the video based on that. And I hope you like the tutorial. If you like this tutorial, give a big thumbs up and share the tutorial. If you like, you can check out my channel and the tutorials. I hope my tutorial will make you happy. And if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. I will try to solve every question you have. If this video is helpful for you, please give a big thumbs up on the video. Share the tutorial with your friends and help my channel to grow. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Not just subscribe, also press the bell icon so that you get all the notifications of my channel. See you in my next tutorial. Till then, bye. And the most important thing, keep learning.